time in years, it appears business owners are ready to start hiring. That is according to a new survey by Focus.com. Thousands of business owners are finally projecting an increase in sales and profitability for 2011. So what sectors of the economy are ready to grow? Joining us, overwhelmingly optimistic outlook by the small businesses who took part. Down on the hiring trends, obviously ahead of the September payrolls report tomorrow. 38% of your respondents say they are increasing their workforce. So specifically in what areas, and why do you think that is? Tomorrow, people aren't that optimistic. They're expecting unemployment to remain elevated above 9.5%. So is there a bit of a disconnect? Why do you think the people you're talking to are feeling more confident about hiring when the nationwide picture is still quite doubtful? Look, there's still a lot of concern. And the main thing is economic uncertainty. And this is what's been plaguing people across the board for many, many months at this point. So what do you think it is? What would the one thing be to help clear up some of this findings with us? Appreciate it.
Thank you, Lori.
All right, Chris, back on over to you.
All right, thank you, Lori.
Good stuff, Robert. Many thanks for that. Let's give you an update now further on the markets. Break it down a little bit. You just heard Robert explain to us that stocks are a little bit lower here today ahead of tomorrow's.
Essentially market-wide.
Outperformers.
A lot of these retailers, BB was one of them, I believe. So it's a mixed bag. But I think in general, those retail numbers, those same-store sales numbers were pretty good, maybe a little bit better than expected in general.
I like how Nicole put it, the fragile consumer, which couldn't explain it quicker and more accurately in these uncertain times.
No question about it. And all
an improvement from
6 months.
Week. But still elevated, and we need to get a lot lower on a consistent basis to have any make any improvement in the overall unemployment picture.
We'll see tomorrow the big labor report before the opening bell. All right, it is with mixed emotions that I bring you this next story.
Oh, dear me.
Charlie, the smoking chimp, has died. Charlie picked up the smoking habit from visitors to his South African zoo. He did manage to kick the habit before his death, so good for you, Charlie, and going cold turkey. Now, don't feel so sad, though. Charlie lived a long life, 52 years. Now, most chimps have a life expectancy of around 40, so despite the smoking habit, Charlie lived a long and prosperous life. Like I've told you before, Lori, and this goes without saying, men love monkeys, midgets, and the Three Stooges, not necessarily in that order, but all men love those things.
Pick two, any two.
Period. I have to pick two of those?
Of my fingers.
Oh.
You know the
yeah.
The Three
oh,
Stooges.
When you do this.
Yes.
You gotta be like, nice guy. All right.
I try to play in with your guy stuff. And inside, look at the NFL's playbook to bring in younger stuff, Chris. All right, so coming up next hour, you won't want to miss this. Brian Sullivan, live in Dallas. All energized about his guest. Brian, do tell us why. Really impressed, Brian, who never fails, comes up
next
short.
Year. That's my goal, is to learn Korean next year.
You knew it was Korean. It wasn't sure which language it was. All right, Brian, we'll look forward to that. Charlie Gasparino, meantime, has got some news on the very latest round of interest.